I have a question for you. How much of your body is human? I'll let you think about that for a moment. Now, I'm not accusing you of being a human-alien hybrid. In fact, I will say that every one of you could answer this question saying 100% of your body is human, and I would agree with you. Sort of. Here's another question for you. How many cells on your body are human cells? If you consider that question, then you know that there are bacteria, yeast, and fungi all resting within and on your body at any given moment. But are they a part of your body, or are they just visitors? How substantial are these microbes to your biology? Well, as it turns out, they are remarkably substantial. There's roughly 30 trillion human cells in the average human body, which is a pretty large number. But it's estimated that there are 10 times the number of bacterial cells on the human body at any given time. That's 300 trillion bacterial cells that you're carrying. 300 trillion is an astronomical number that's difficult for us to conceptualize. We can use astronomy to help us visualize this number. One way to imagine this large number is to think of the Milky Way galaxy. If we're somewhat generous with our estimation, there's 300 billion stars in our galaxy. That means it would take 1,000 Milky Way galaxies for the number of stars to equal the number of bacteria on a single typical healthy human. Here's another way of thinking of it. A single bacterium is very tiny. It's only 1 micron in length on average. That's 1/1,000,000th of a meter. However, if we were to line up all the bacteria on a typical human body, the total length would be 300 million meters. That's 300,000 kilometers, or a little over 186,000 miles. That's long enough to wrap around the Earth over 7 times, and all of these guys are inside of you. By weight, this collection of microbes inside of you weighs roughly 4 pounds. That's about the same weight as your brain, your liver, or 2 pairs of lungs. In fact, this microbial ecology, otherwise known as the microbiome, could be thought of as a body organ like the liver because it's necessary for your survival. In short, without your microbiome, you'd be dead. Microbiomes are essential for a wide range of metabolic and immunological and developmental processes, including host metabolism, vitamin production, education of the immune system, defense against pathogens, and shaping the gastrointestinal health. Microbiomes mitigate colon function, impact inflammation and cancer, and have been associated with obesity and diabetes, anxiety and depression, oral health, cardiovascular disease, and many aspects of vaginal health. Human microbiomes are now recognized as a major player in health and disease and are a major part of you. Interventions based on microbiomes appear to be more feasible than interventions based on human genes. It is now known that microbiomes can be impacted by antibiotics, prebiotics, probiotics, and diet, providing hopeful interventions once an understanding of the biology of these ecosystems is obtained. Yet, there's much work to be done in understanding this biology. Understanding how humans and their microbiomes co-evolved provides the wisdom needed to make informed decisions about microbiome medical interventions. Interestingly, it's not only these bacteria that are an essential part of your biology, but also the viruses. Viruses have a bad reputation. People often think of viruses as nasty disease-causing agents of destruction, when in fact, it's a very small minority of viruses that are involved in human infectious disease. Consider there are 10 times the number of viruses in a typical healthy body than bacteria. That means there are 100 times more viruses in your body than human cells. We call this viral ecology a virome. Virome research is still at a very early and exciting stage, but it's quite clear that the virome, much like the microbiome, is an essential part of you. Okay, we can accept that your body is much more than your human cells, but also the substantial and remarkable microbiome and virome that you carry. In this respect, you are a superorganism, a composite life form, but it goes much deeper than the microbes outside of your cells. Much, much deeper.